Oke, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, good morning. How are you today? Hope you great and healthy. Student, welcome back to the science class with me, teacher Eka. Before we start to learn, we have to pray together. Let's begin. Okay, finish everyone. So, student, today we are going to continue our lesson. Okay, then you can open your textbook on page 14, yeah? Okay. Okay. Let's continue our lesson and then you can open your textbook on page 14, yeah? What can we find in a pond? Apa yang bisa kita temui? Ya, di kolam. Okay, then what animals can be found in a pond? Fishes live in water. They feed on algae, water plants, and even insects. Algae are plants that grow on the pond surface. Okay, and then many fish do not like direct sunlight, so they like to find shelter in the shade of water plant. Okay, then everyone. Okay, this is algae, yeah, algae in a pond, yeah, algae, last week, I read that algae is ganggang, yeah. Okay, fish live in water, ya. Ikan hidup di dalam air. They feed on algae. Mereka memakan alga, ya. Water plant, tumbuhan air, and also even insect, beberapa jenis insekta. What is algae? Algae are plants that grow on the pond surface. Jadi, alga merupakan tanaman, ya, yang hidup di permukaan kolam. Many fish do not like direct sunlight. Kebanyakan ikan tidak suka ya dengan sinar matahari langsung. So they like to find shelter. Mereka suka menemukan shelter, tempat berlindung, in the shade of water plant. Biasanya di bawah tumbuhan air ya. Okay, then where are the fish hiding? Where are the fish hiding? Di manakah kira-kira ikan bersembunyi? Okay, look at this picture, everyone. Koi like to hide under the broad leaves of the water lilies. Jadi ikan koi ini dia berlindung, bernaung di bawah daun dari water lilies atau lili air ya. Okay, then for your information, duck. Yeah, this is duck and this is snail. Yeah, duck and snail also feed on algae. Yeah, biasanya bebek dan juga snail. Yeah, atau siput dia memakan algae. Yeah, duck and snail also feed on algae. Okay. Then let's continue. Okay, what can we find in a pond? Apa yang bisa kita temukan di kolam? Look, what is this insect walking on the water surface? Yeah, in this, it is a pond skater. It eats insect that has fallen into the water surface. Pond attract many other kinds of animals. And then what animals can be found near a pond? Okay, what animals can be found near a pond? Lalu binatang apa saja yang bisa kita temukan ya di sekitar kolam? Okay, wait. Okay. Okay, I hear frog croaking. Can you spot it? Yeah. Katanya saya mendengar suara kodok. Bisakah kalian menemukan di mana kodok tersebut? Okay, I'll bet. This is frog croaking, ribbit, ribbit, like that, yeah? And this is the frog. Okay, and then we can find dragonfly, and then frog, yeah? Okay, what animals can be found near a pond? Binatang apa saja yang kita bisa temukan di dekat kolam, ya? Yeah? The first one is dragonfly. The second is frog, yeah? And then dragonflies like to fly near the surface of pond. They feed on insects such as mosquitoes, which live near ponds. Dragonfly lay their eggs in the ponds too. Yeah, lay their eggs. Yeah, bertelur. Okay, jadi capung itu bertelur lah di kolam, ya. Dragonflies laying eggs in water, ya. Biasanya capung itu bertelurnya di dalam air. And then this is I'm the young of the dragonfly, katanya. Saya adalah bentuk mudanya dari capung. I'm the young of the dragonfly. Okay, and I grow up in water. Dan biasanya, ya, bentuk muda dari capung ini tinggalnya di dalam air. Okay, then frogs like to stay near pond because they need to keep their bodies wet. They feed on insects such as dragonflies and mosquitoes. Frogs lay their eggs in ponds too. Ya, okay. Jadi di sini biasanya katak itu suka, ya, berada di sekitaran kolam. Kenapa? Karena katak membutuhkan tubuhnya supaya tetap basah, ya, atau tetap lembab. Kulitnya supaya tetap basah atau lembab. They feed on insects. Biasanya katak itu memakan beberapa jenis serangga, such as dragonflies, seperti capung, and mosquitoes, dan nyamuk, ya. Frog lays their eggs in a pond too. Dan biasanya frogs, ya, atau katak juga bertelur, lay their eggs in a pond. Ya, biasanya bertelur juga di air, ya, di air kolam. Okay, and then you can look at this picture. We can find some frog eggs. Ya, kita bisa menemukan beberapa telur katak di sini, ya. And then this is tadpole. Tadpole in bahasa Berudu. Okay, I'm a tadpole, the young of frog. Berudu itu merupakan bentuk kecilnya, ya, atau bentuk mudanya dari katak. And I grow up in water too. Dan biasanya berudu itu dia hidupnya di air juga, ya. Okay, then let's continue. Okay, I'm going to eat you, say dragonflies to mosquitoes. And then the frog said, I'm going to eat you, ya. Dan katak mengatakan bahwa aku akan memakanmu, ya, capung dan juga, ya, nyamuk. Okay, then what can we find on a beach? Lalu apa yang bisa kita temukan di pantai, ya, beach or seashore? Ya, okay, look at the beach. What plants can we find? Kira-kira tumbuhan apa saja yang bisa kita temukan di pantai? Okay, coconut trees often grow on the seashore. They grow well in sandy soil under plenty of sunlight. And then the second, we can find seaweeds. Yeah, seaweeds grow in a shallow seawater or on rocky shores. Yeah. And then there seem to be fewer types of plants here than in a garden. Why? Ya, katanya kenapa di sini hanya sedikit sekali tanaman yang bisa tumbuh dibandingkan dengan di kebun atau di taman. Kenapa, ya? Because the beach has sandy soil. Ya, karena di Beach itu memiliki sandy soil ya, tanahnya yang berpasir ya. So just a little or a fewer types of plants can live there. Ya. Just coconut and seaweed. Okay. Then, what animals can we find on a beach? Lalu binatang apa saja yang bisa kita temukan di beach? Ya. Okay, for the first one, seagulls. Seagulls come here to look for food, such as crabfish and shellfish. And then, look at this. This is crab. Yeah. Crabs often hide in the rocks too. Yeah. Crabs live in holes in the sand, and crabs often hide in the rocks too. Jadi crabs itu ya, kepiting bisa hidup di lubang pasir ini ya, atau bisa di bawah batu, bukan di bawah batu, tapi bersembunyi di batu ya. Okay, and then shellfish are often washed off into the beach. Ya, di sini ada kerang ya. Okay. Then let's continue. How does the environment affect living thing? Different living thing are found in different environment. An environment that suits one living thing may not suit another. So look at this environment. How are they similar and how are they different? We have beach and garden. So, what are the similar between beach and garden, and what are different between beach and garden? Yeah. Then, a garden is usually a bright and sunny place. So, is a beach. Yeah. Okay, garden. This is garden. This is beach. Yeah. A garden is usually a bright and sunny place. So is a beach too. Ya, jadi sama ya, persamaan dari environment, lingkungan. Garden, taman, dan juga beach, pantai, itu sama-sama bright, terang ya, and sunny place. Ya. However, a garden is covered in soil. Okay, a garden is covered in soil, but beach is covered in sand. Ya, perbedaannya kalau di taman itu ya tanahnya terdiri dari tanah ya. Kalau yang di beach itu terdiri dari pasir. Ya, tersusun atas pasir. And then soil can hold more water than sand. It is also contain more nutrients than sand. Yeah, many plants grow well in soil but not in sand. Okay, for example, a variety of plants growing in a garden soil. Yeah, a variety of plants growing in a garden soil. And then look at this. A plant need to keep their skin moist. If their skin dries out, they cannot breathe. They cannot live in a sand. Yeah, earthworm wriggling in the soil. So if the earthworm live in the sand, yeah, they cannot breathe, and they will die because earthworm needs their bodies always moist. Or wet, ya. Jadi ketika cacing hidup di tanah yang berpasir, itu mereka tidak bisa bernapas, ya, dan akan menyebabkan mereka mati, ya. Kenapa? Karena tubuh cacing kulitnya harus selalu lembab, ya. Okay. Then for your information, untuk informasi bagi kalian, earthworm breathe using their skin. Ya. Jadi cacing itu bernapas dengan menggunakan kulitnya, ya. Different with a human, ya. Berbeda dengan manusia. Kalau manusia breathe using lungs, ya, paru-paru. Ya, kalau cacing using their skin. Ya. So the earthworm need to keep their skin moist, ya. Okay, and then let's continue. Coconut trees, on the other hand, can grow well in sand but not in soil. Sand provides a drier environment as it allows water to drain away. Coconut trees growing on a sandy beach. Yeah. Coconut trees growing on a sandy beach. Yeah, and then rivers and ponds are filled with fresh water. Rivers and ponds, yeah, refers to sungai. Ponds ko kolam are filled with fresh water, ya, terdiri dari air tawar atau tersusun dari air tawar. The sea is filled with salt water, sedangkan ya air laut itu airnya biasanya asin, ya, salt water. Okay. And then some plants and fish can only live in a fresh water, some can only live in salt water. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, some plants, beberapa tanaman, and fish, dan ikan, can only live in a fresh water, hanya bisa hidup di air tawar, ya. Okay. Some can only live in salt water, dan beberapa hanya bisa hidup di air garam atau air laut, ya. Clownfish, sea sores, and octopus can live in sea water, yeah, but goldfish cannot. Okay, I will inform you. Clownfish, sea horse, and octopus can live in sea water, but yeah. Goldfish cannot. Okay. Clownfish in bahasa ikan badut, ya. Seahorse, kuda laut. And then octopus. And then octopus, what is octopus in bahasa? Okay, look at this. This is octopus, this is seahorse, and this is clownfish, yeah? Okay, and octopus in bahasa is gurita, yeah? Okay. Can live in sea water, bisa hidup di air laut, ya. But goldfish, ikan mas, cannot, because goldfish live in fresh water. Okay, jadi tadi some plants and fish can only live in fresh water, such as goldfish, yeah, and then some can only live in salt water like clownfish, seahorse, and octopus, yeah. And then you can find plants such as cattails and water lettuce in ponds, yeah, and then but not in the sea. Yeah, only a few plants such as seaweeds can survive in salt water. I'll look at this, everyone. This is seaweed, yeah, red seaweed. And these plants live in a salt water or can survive in a salt water. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Look at this. This is beach. So, what's a characteristic or what would describe this environment for beach? It is sandy and hot. Yeah. And then what about leaves litter? Okay, it is damp and shady. Yeah. Damp and shady. This is beach and this is leaves litter. Okay. Then why must we care for the environment? Kenapa kita harus peduli pada lingkungan? Okay, look at this dirty beach. Kita lihat ke lingkungan pantai yang kotor. What things do not belong here? What things do not belong here? The rubbish left by people harms the living thing on the beach. Yeah. And then look at this. This turtle is trapped in a fishing net. Yeah. This turtle is trapped in a fishing net. And then, when an environment is made dirty or damaged, many living things may not survive. They may not be able to find food, keep safe, or have young. Okay, and this, look at this picture, everyone. When trees are cut down, the animals that live in them lose their homes. Yeah, and then look at this picture. Birds lose their homes and even their young when their nests are destroyed. Yeah. And then, living things that share a home depend on one another in many ways. Okay, a chance to just one type of living thing can affect other living things. Okay, for example, look at this boy. Yeah, this boy cutting out the flowers. Yeah, and then the bee said, "Oh no, the flowers are gone." So the butterfly said, "What shall we do? I'm hungry." Ya, lihat di sini ada anak laki-laki ya yang mencabut bunga ya, memetik bunga. Okay, and then the bee said, "Oh no, the flowers are gone." Ya, lebah berkata bahwa tidak, flowers, bunga-bunganya pergi. And then the butterfly said, dan kupu-kupu bilang, "What shall we do?" Apa yang harus kita lakukan? "I'm hungry," saya kelaparan ya. Okay, for your information, bees and also butterflies eat some juicy, okay, nectar ya. Feed on flower, and this butterfly feed nectar, yeah. Okay, and then if the flowers gone, the bees and butterflies cannot feed on a flower, cannot feed nectar, yeah. Okay, and then from this picture, when an environment is made dirty or damaged, ketika suatu lingkungan kotor, kemudian terjadi kerusakan, many living things may not survive. Banyak sekali makhluk hidup yang tidak bisa bertahan hidup. Yeah, they may not be able to find food, keep safe, or have young. Mereka tidak bisa menemukan makanan, kemudian menemukan tempat mereka berlindung, ya, or have young, atau memiliki keturunan. Yeah, and look at this. When trees are cut down, ketika pohon ditebang, the animals that live in them lose their home. Binatang atau hewan yang hidup ya di pohon tersebut akan kehilangan rumahnya ya. Birds lose their homes ya, termasuk burung juga ya. Burung kehilangan rumahnya, even their young dan juga anak-anaknya. When their nests are destroyed, ketika sarangnya itu rusak ya, jatuh dari pohon karena pohonnya ditebang. Okay, and then everyone, this is why we should protect and care for the environment. Itulah kenapa kita harus menjaga atau peduli terhadap lingkungan. So how can we help? Lalu bagaimanakah kita bisa membantu? For the first, we should throw litter into dustbin. Ya, kita membuang sampah pada tong sampah. Ya, and then we should plant more trees. Kita harus banyak menanam tanaman. Okay, and then we should help see animals that have been washed into the shores as your friends for help first. Ya, kita juga harus mengembalikan binatang yang berasal dari air. Karena dia terbawa oleh ombak, misalkan dia jadi berada di tepi pantai, ya. Kita harus meminta bantuan dari orang dewasa atau orang tua kita untuk mengembalikan binatang tersebut ke habitat asalnya, yaitu ke laut, ya. And then we should not take eggs from bird nests. Kita tidak boleh mengambil telur burung, ya, dari sarangnya. Okay, and then we should not pick all the flowers we see. Kita tidak boleh ya memetik bunga yang kita lihat, ya. Okay, then now let's discuss about our lesson today. And for the first, I'm going to call Rashid and Hafish. For the first, I'm going to call Rashid and Hafish. Okay, wait everyone, I had trouble. So wait a minute. Okay, let's review first, yeah? Okay, what can we find in a pond? There are some living things live in or near a pond. Okay, and then for the first, let's talk about the plants. What plants can you find in a pond? Yeah, what plants can you find in a pond? Apa saja tumbuhan yang bisa kita temui ya atau temukan di kolam atau di dekat kolam? Okay, for the first, we can find grasses. Kita bisa menemukan rumput. And then mosses, ya, lumut, algae, ganggang, and then water lotus, ya, teratai, water lettuce, selada air, water hyacinth, eceng gondok, ya, water lilies, lili air, and cattails, ekor kucing, ya. And then, what animals can we find in a pond? Lalu, binatang apa yang bisa kita temukan di kolam atau di dekat kolam, in a pond or near pond. Yeah, the first one we can find fish. Yeah, and then after that we can find snail. We can find a duck. We can find frog, dragonfly, and another. Yeah, and then everyone, fish, it's live in water, and usually they feed algae, water plants, and even insects. Yeah, and many fish do not like direct sunlight. Yeah, they like to find shelter in the shades of the water plants. Okay, and then, yeah, let's talk about what can we find in a pond. And for the first, I'm going to call Rashid and Hafiz. Yeah. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Rashid. Hello, Rashid. How are you today?
Teacher, tadi teachernya telepon aku, tapi aku.
Okay, Rashid. Okay, Rashid, how are you? Okay, so sorry. Okay, Rashid, how are you today?
I'm alright.
Okay, good. Then, have you got breakfast? Rashid, have you got breakfast? Okay, Rashid, please unmute your audio, yeah. Have you got breakfast, Rashid?
What, teacher?
Have you got breakfast?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay, then let's...
I have got breakfast.
Okay, then let's wait. I'm going to call your partner, Hafiz. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Hafiz. How are you today, Hafiz? Okay, and then how are you, Hafiz?
Aku mau lihat.
Okay. Good job. Rashid and Hafiz. Let's say hey to each other. Please say hey to each other. Hafiz, please turn on your camera and your microphone, Rashid. And then please say hey to each other. Hello everyone, are you there? Hafiz, what are you doing?
Is that a drone?
Rashid, turn on your camera, Rashid. Rashid, please turn on your camera, Rashid. Yeah, okay, Hafiz and Rashid, please say hi to each other. Make greeting, everyone. Make greeting first. Please. Disapa, temannya disapa. Hafiz said, how are you today, Rashid?
Yeah.
Hafiz said, how are you?
Lupa nama. Sekarang aku gak bisa dengar, koneksinya buruk.
Okay. Hafiz said, how are you, Rashid?
Pakai wifi, semuanya pakai wifi.
Oke. Okay. Oke, okay. Teacher sudah pakai wifi. Oke, okay. So Rashid, can you hear my voice? Rashid bisa dengar suara teacher? Can you hear my voice, Rashid and Hafiz? Hafiz, can you hear my voice? Hafiz, can you hear my voice? Yes, okay. Then I want to ask you, Rashid and Hafiz. Yeah, I want to ask you, Rashid and Hafiz, who want to answer first? The question is, what animals can be found in a pond? Who want to answer first? What animals can be found in a pond? Okay, Hafiz, tell me, what animals can be found in a pond? Okay, fish, and then? Frog. And then what else? Dragonfly, goldfish. Okay, and then what else? Again, then what else, everyone? Okay, good job. Okay. Okay. Okay, good job. Good job, Hafiz and Rashid. Now I want to ask you, what animals can be found in a beach?
Connection-nya buruk banget, aku nggak bisa denger.
Oke.
Okay. Ada yang belum pakai WiFi?
Teacher sudah pakai WiFi. Oke, okay, Rashid. Rashid and Hafiz, can you tell me what animals can be found in a beach? What animals can be found crab. In a beach? Okay, crab.
Yeah, crab.
Okay,
crab.
And then what else?
Shark.
Shark.
Hammerhead. Sharks.
Okay, and he was. Yeah, and then what about Hafiz? Hafiz, tell me, what animals can be found in a beach? Okay. Okay.
Kerang yang di dalamnya ada mungkin
Okay, shellfish. Oh, sorry, shell, ya, yeah, shell. Okay. Okay. And then what else? Apa lagi? Okay. 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 See. Okay. Good. Okay. Good job, mashallah. Okay. Good job. Okay. Good job, Hafiz and Rashid. Thank you very much for helping me to answer this question. See you soon everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye. Bye. Okay, then now I'm going to call. Fawaz and Faizan. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Fawaz.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
How are you today? Alhamdulillah, I'm very well. Then Fawaz, have you got breakfast? Yes, okay, please wait, I'm going to call your partner Faizan. Okay, Faizan, if you watch YouTube, please pick up your phone. Oke, okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Faizan. Assalamualaikum, Faizan. How are you today, Faizan? How are you today? Alhamdulillah, I'm very well. Thank you for asking, Faizan. Then Fawaz, Faizan. Okay, I want to ask you. Teacher mau tanya ke Fawaz dan ke Faizan, ya. Yeah. Yeah, and the question is, what living thing can you find on a beach? What living thing can you find on a beach? What living thing, makhluk hidup apa yang kalian temukan di pantai, di laut? Okay, sound that's clear. Okay, let's wait. Okay, is that better now? Okay, I will repeat the question. What living thing can you find on a beach? What living thing? Makhluk hidup apa saja? Or what animal? Okay. What animals and what plant can you find on a beach?
I found them in the beach.
Okay, and then?
And seashell.
Seashell.
Crab.
Okay. And then what plants? Tanamannya apa? What plants can you find?
Coconut tree
and seaweed. Yeah, coconut tree and seaweed. Okay, then Faizan and Fawaz. How does the environment affect living thing? Oh, my sound's not clear. Okay. Okay. Fawaz and Faizan, can you tell me difference and similar between beach and garden? How are they similar and how are they different between beach and garden? Okay, and then what's different between, how are they different?
Garden is popular inside, but beach is popular inside.
Okay, difference between beach and garden, the difference between beach and garden. Garden is covered in soil, but a beach is covered in sand. Yeah, good job. And what about the similarity? How are they similar? Yeah, garden and beach are usually bright and sunny place. Yeah, good job, mashallah. And then I think enough for today, Fawaz and Faizan. Thank you very much for helping me to answer this question. And see you soon, everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye, Fawaz. Bye, Faizan. Okay, then now I'm going to call Hussein and Aga. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Husein.
Waalaikumsalam, teacher.
How are you today?
I'm fine, thank you. And you, teacher?
Alhamdulillah, I'm very well. Thank you for asking. Then, Husein, please wait. I'm going to call your partner, Aga. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Aga. How are you today, Aga? Okay, alhamdulillah, I'm very well. Thank you for asking. Everyone, have you got breakfast? Kalian sudah sarapan? Yes, okay, good job. And then I want to ask you, Husein and Aga, for the first question. What have you learned for today? Apa yang sudah kalian pelajari hari ini? What have you learned for today? Tell me, what have you learned for today? Okay, one by one. Okay, please mute your microphone first. Dimute dulu speakernya, audionya dimute. Okay, then I want to ask Husein first. Husein, what have you learned for today? What have you learned for today, Husein? What have you learned? Apa yang sudah Husein pelajari hari ini?
Apa ya?
Husein belajar apa saja hari ini? Tadi teacher Eka menerangkan apa? Okay, that's about environment. Okay, good. And then, okay, and then what else? Apa lagi? And then what else, Husein? Apa lagi yang Husein pelajari? Just environment. Tell me, what about environment? What is environment? Just it? Really? Husein tadi nonton YouTube gak? Have you watched YouTube? Do you watch YouTube now?
Yes,
and then what have you learned? Okay, tell me about what can we find on a beach? What can we find on a beach, Husein?
pantai bisa atau di laut bisa menemukan apa saja? What can we find on a beach? Hussein, di pantai ada apa saja? Okay, then Aga, what can you find on a beach? Aga, what can you find on a beach? Okay, everyone, I'm so sorry because I have some trouble with the connection. I tried to using Wi-Fi and also the mobile data, but doesn't connect, yeah? So I'm so sorry, everyone. I cannot call you one by one. And for this lesson, we can continue on Google Meet, yeah? And I will try to explain about our lesson today on a Google Meet, yeah. So I'm so sorry because this is some trouble, yeah. We have some trouble in this connection. I will try using mobile data and also Wi-Fi, but didn't connect, yeah. So I cannot call you one by one, yeah. Teacher minta maaf ya, karena di sini koneksinya sangat buruk ya. Teacher sudah mencoba pakai Wi-Fi dan juga sudah mencoba pakai mobile data ya, sama-sama tidak bisa ya. Jadi koneksinya sangat buruk ya. Jadi untuk lebih jelasnya nanti teacher akan sampaikan di Google Meet ya tentang pembelajaran hari ini. Okay, jadi sekarang kalian cukup mendengarkan tayangan YouTube-nya saja ya. Nanti untuk pertanyaannya atau ditelepon one by one-nya nanti pada saat Google Meet ya. Okay, then I will continue our lesson, everyone, and maybe I will review our lesson for today ya. Okay, how does the environment affect living things? Different living things are found in a different environment. Ya, beberapa makhluk hidup itu kan ditemukan pada beberapa lingkungan yang berbeda atau habitat yang berbeda. An environment that suits one living thing may not suit another. Ya, ada beberapa makhluk hidup yang bisa hidup di tempat tertentu, ya, dan makhluk hidup lain tidak bisa hidup di tempat tersebut, tapi di tempat yang berbeda. Okay, look at this picture. There are beach and a garden. So what similarity and different between beach and garden? How are they look similar and how are they look different? Okay, a garden is usually a bright and sunny place, so it is a beach. And then, however, a garden is covered in soil and beach is covered in sand. So, a garden, because covered in soil, so there are leaves, many organism or living thing. Yeah, but in a beach, there are so a little plant or fewer plant can live in beach. Yes, yes, coconut trees and seaweed. Ya, karena garden, kebun atau taman, tanahnya tersusun atas tanah, ya, banyak sekali makhluk hidup yang bisa survive, stay alive di sana. Ya, tapi akan tetapi di pantai karena beach is covered in sand, karena tanahnya berpasir, only fewer, hanya sedikit plants can live in there, tanaman yang bisa hidup di sana. Such as coconut trees and seaweed. Hanya coconut trees atau pohon kelapa dan juga seaweed, ya, rumput laut. Okay. Soil can hold more water. Ya, tanah itu bisa mengumpulkan, mengakumulasi, ya, banyak air. More than sand, dibandingkan dengan pasir. Ya, it is also contain more nutrients. Ya, tanah juga mengandung banyak nutrisi than sand, dibandingkan dengan pasir. So many plants grow well in soil, sehingga banyak sekali tumbuhan yang bisa hidup dengan baik di tanah, ya, but not in sand, tapi tidak di pasir, ya. Kalau di pasir tadi just coconut trees and seaweed, I mean. Okay, a variety of plants growing in a garden soil. And then earthworm need to keep their skin moist. Ya, yeah. Earthworm cacing membutuhkan tubuhnya selalu lembab. Ya, yeah. Okay. If their skin dries out, ketika tubuhnya kering, they cannot breathe. Mereka tidak bisa bernafas. They cannot live in sand. Sehingga mereka tidak bisa bertahan hidup di tanah yang berpasir. Ya, yeah. Okay. Then, coconut trees on the other hand can grow well in sand but not in soil. Beberapa jenis kelapa atau pohon kelapa itu akan tumbuh baik, ya, atau tumbuh dengan cepat di karakteristik tanahnya yang berpasir, ya, dibandingkan dengan tanah yang biasa. Okay, sand provides a drier environment as it always water to dry away. Okay. This is a coconut trees. Okay, this is the coconut trees, yeah. And this coconut trees growing on a sandy beach. Ya, yeah, dan pohon kelapa ini hidup di sandy beach. Ya, yeah, di pantai yang berpasir. Okay, rivers and ponds, sungai dan juga kolam are filled with fresh water. Biasanya mengandung air tawar, ya. Yeah. The sea, air laut, is filled with salt water. Mengandung air garam, ya. Jadi rasanya asin. Okay, some plants and fish can only live in fresh water. Beberapa tanaman dan juga ikan hanya bisa hidup di air tawar. Okay, some can only live in salt water. Dan beberapa di antaranya hanya bisa hidup di air laut. Okay, clownfish in bahasa ikan badut, seahorse kuda laut, and octopus gurita can live in seawater, bisa hidup di air laut, but goldfish cannot. Tapi ikan mas tidak bisa. Why? Because goldfish can live in fresh water, can only live in fresh water. Ya, jadi goldfish itu hanya bisa hidup di air tawar, ya. Okay, you can find plants such as cattail and water lotus in a pond. Ya, kalian bisa menemukan ekor kucing, ya, paku ekor kucing, kemudian water lotus teratai in a pond, di kolam, but not in the sea. Tapi kalian tidak bisa menemukan itu di pantai, ya. Only a few plants, hanya sedikit tanaman such as seaweed can survive in salt water, yang bisa bertahan hidup di air yang asin, ya. Just seaweed, ya. Okay, then Why must we care for environment? For the environment. Ya, kenapa kita hanya bisa? Kenapa kita harus peduli terhadap lingkungan? Ya. Okay, look at this dirty beach. Lihat ke pantai yang kotor, ya. What things do not belong here? Ya. The rubbish left by people harm the living thing on a beach. Ya, sampah yang ditinggalkan oleh orang-orang yang berkunjung ke pantai akan mengakibatkan, ya, atau akan membahayakan living thing, makhluk hidup yang ada di beach, yang ada di pantai, ya. For example, this turtle is trapped in the fishing net. Ya, this turtle is trapped in a fishing net. Di sini, ya, turtle-nya terperangkap, ya, di jaring ikan, ya, di jaring-jaring ikan. Okay, then, when an environment is made dirty or damaged, many living things may not survive. Ketika lingkungan itu kotor dan juga mengalami kerusakan, banyak makhluk hidup yang tidak bisa bertahan hidup, ya. They may not be able to find food. Mereka tidak bisa menemukan makanan, keep safe, ya, menemukan tempat berlindung, or have young, atau bahkan menghasilkan keturunan. Ya, when trees are cut down, the animals live in them lose their homes. Ya, birds lose their homes and even their young when their nests are destroyed. Okay, and the living things that share a home depend on one another in many ways. A change to just one type of living thing can affect other living things, such as the flowers. Yeah, when the flowers cutting down or put off, yeah, the bees and the butterflies cannot feed nectar. Yeah. And then, this is why we should protect and care for the environment. Itulah kenapa kita harus peduli terhadap lingkungan. So, what should we do? How can we help? Ya, apa yang harus kita lakukan? Apa yang bisa kita bantu? Ya, for the first, we should throw litter into dustbin. Kita membuang sampah pada tempatnya, ya, pada tong sampah. We should plant more trees. Kita harus banyak menanam tanaman. Ya, yeah, we should help the animals. Kita harus menolong, membantu, ya, yeah, the animals, hewan laut that have been washed onto the seashores, yang berada di tepi pantai, ya, yeah, yang terbawa oleh ombak. Ask your parents for help first, ya. Yeah. Kalian harus memberitahukan atau meminta tolong kepada orang tua kalian, ya, yeah, agar bisa mengembalikan si animals binatang laut tersebut ke habitat asalnya, ya. Yeah. And then we should not take eggs from the bird's nest. Kita tidak boleh mengambil telur dari sarang burung, ya. Yeah. Okay, then we should not pick all the flower we see. Kita tidak boleh mengambil atau memetik, ya, semua bunga yang kita lihat, ya. Yeah. Then everyone, I think enough for today. Thank you very much for joining this class. Thank you for your attention. And I'm so sorry because we had some trouble with the connection. And last time I'll try to using Wi-Fi and also mobile data, but it's didn't connect. I have to call you one by one. Okay. Inshallah, for on a Google Meet, we can talk more about our lesson today, and I will ask you one by one, yeah. Okay, everyone, let's read Hamdallah, Alhamdulillahirrabbilalamin, and then forget to read Doa Kafaratul Majlis. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, ashadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Okay, then everyone, I think enough for today. See you soon on Google Meet at 10 a.m. Yeah. Thank you very much. See you. Bye bye. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.